Good afternoon, you're with the news here on Mirror Now. My name is Apurva Sridhar. Let's begin with our top focus story, a disturbing one rather, where two incidents of mob violence, both coming in from Madhya Pradesh's Neemuch. In the first case, three men were thrashed and assaulted by a mob on the suspicion of goat theft. And in the other, a man was beaten to death for stealing peacock in Neemuch. In fact, in the first instance that is coming to light, three men were thrashed on the suspicion of stealing goats in Madhya Pradesh's Neemuch. The bikes of the men were set on fire by the locals when they were allegedly trying to flee the spot. The three accused of stealing have been arrested by the cops. And the other hand, six people who have been arrested for assaulting the accused. An FIR has already been filed against them. In fact, in the second incident that we're bringing to you, yet again, there is an incident of mob violence again coming in from Neemuch in Madhya Pradesh. A man was brutally thrashed for allegedly stealing peacocks. He was immediately taken to the hospital where he died during treatment. 10 accused have been arrested for the attack and 5 peacocks have been recovered. This is, of course, a shocking trend that is coming in at this point, and this is extremely serious because not only has there been an increase in the trend, but there has been no end to mob violence at the moment. My colleague Govind joining me on the phone line with further updates on this. Govind, this is an extremely disturbing trend. Let's not forget that mob violence is a serious criminal offense. And despite knowing that, there have been instance after instance coming to light, only highlighting that there are people who still think that they can take law into their own hands and engage in mob violence.
Exactly. I tell you one thing, that even after CM Kamalnath has announced that they are just forming the law for such kind of mob lynching, in which if mob lynching is come in existence, the punishment would be just given to those who are involved in this incident. But surprisingly, it's not still stopping in Madhya Pradesh. Couple of incidences from in the same sequence from the same district of Madhya Pradesh. Two instances like this in which mob lynching came in existence. And in these two incidences, one of the incidences is that in which a man has to lost his life also. So this is quite of a very serious offense is being committed there continuously in Madhya Pradesh, in which Neemuch district where two instances there. In one instance, those who were involved in stealing goats, they were just caught by the villagers, and later their motorcycle also and placed by blazers, and they have been just arrested by the police, and later 6 more also arrested who were involved in this mob lynching. And then one more instance also there in which 10 villagers have been arrested by police for killing a man who was accused of killing the peacocks, the national bird of our country. So this is exactly what the very heinous crime is still not stopping. Many conversations are going on for
absolutely
law for
absolutely. And Govind, let's not forget that mob violence and lynching is in fact a very serious criminal offense, and it invites stringent punishment under the law. And there have already been directions that have been put in place by the Supreme Court last year, which also observed how heinous and how criminal mob lynching is. Despite the directions coming in from the Supreme Court, do you feel that perhaps the state government in many ways has failed to probably put things into action, put a deterrent in place as far as the entire case of mob violence is concerned?
Absolutely. Supreme Court is very serious for such kind of incidences in which mob lynching comes in existence. It's being protested even before. Many organizations have been just protesting for that.
All right, we'll try and reconnect with Govind in just a bit. But that, of course, is a very serious case that is being highlighted. Two instances of mob violence reported from the same place. This is Madhya Pradesh's Neemuch area. On one hand, there are three men who were thrashed on the suspicion of theft. They were thrashed brutally. Their bikes were set ablaze by 6 people. And the visuals on the left of your screens there indicate the manner in which, in broad daylight, in the presence of so many people on the road, These three men have been dragged and thrashed by the locals on a mere suspicion of theft. On the other hand, there's a man who's been beaten to death for stealing peacocks, and 10 of them have been arrested. But this clearly indicates a rather dangerous trend at this point on how this is a very serious case which every government must look into with all seriousness. Let me quickly take in that point from Mr. Hitesh Bajpayee joining me on the phone line. Mr. Bajpayee, this is a very, very serious trend. And what is even more shocking is that despite the Supreme Court intervening, putting down a list of several guidelines and directions for the state to follow, especially to curb mob violence, we are just looking at an upward trend when it comes to these cases.
Look, these are all law and order issues and especially not related to any caste, color, religion or whatever it is. So whenever we give a shelter to these people under religious activity, they get strengthened. So this is a simple issue of law and order. Everyone who is seen doing all these lawlessness must be booked by the agencies immediately, because we have got a beat system. And this is not a very rural area. Neemuch is a district place. Look, if this is the kind of thing which is happening in the district place, then you can very well imagine what is the situation in rural areas where people are not safe. Their public life is also not safe. So this is the law and order situation right now in Madhya Pradesh. And the Kamal Nath has to really take care of all these things. He must immediately take a note of this your coverage too, so that he can decide what right. can be done. And over 8,000, nearly around 9,000 transfers of police officials has been done for the last 3 months after Lok Sabha elections. So the government machinery right. is busy in transfer.
So Mr. Bajpayee, in your opinion, Mr. Bajpayee, in your opinion, this is a complete breakdown of the law and order situation in the state of Madhya Pradesh. Quickly taking that point across to Mr. K.K. Mishra of the Congress joining us on the broadcast. Mr. Mishra, do you think this is a complete breakdown of the law and order situation in the state of Madhya Pradesh? Because clearly there is something that is allowing these locals, allowing these people to take law into their own hands, and perhaps even believe that it is okay to go ahead and beat up, thrash up, even kill a person for any kind of suspicion of theft or anything.
देखिए ना सबसे पहले तो मैं कंडेम करना चाहूँगा कि बीजेपी के नेता चरण कमलनाथ सरकार ने 9,000 ट्रांसफर किए हैं और करना किसी भी राज्य सरकार का मौलिक अधिकार है. He knows, सभी लोग जानते हैं कि क्या किया है और मॉब बीजेपी का जहाँ तक प्रश्न है उसके लिए सरकार ने अभी एक अधिनियम बना दिया है. हमें यह देखना होगा कि वोट टेकिंग करने वाले कौन लोग हैं, इस विचारधारा से प्रेरित उसके पीछे उनका उद्देश्य क्या है, इन सब पर भी हमें देखना होगा. और हम किसी भी तरह उत्साहित नहीं करेंगे. मुख्यमंत्री जी का स्पष्ट निर्देश है तो उससे बख्श नहीं जाएगा.
आप सरकार चला रहे हैं, आपको कौन सी विचारधारा दिखी इनमें, बताइए श्रीमान.
किसी भी प्रकार की मुझे सलाह नहीं है. आई एम टू लर्न टू एंटर और मैं उनको जवाब देने के लिए तैयार हूँ.
अरे भाई, देश को जवाब नहीं देंगे, विपक्ष को जवाब नहीं देंगे. मिश्रा जी, इतनी भी आप में विनम्रता नहीं बची कि इतनी वायलेंस हो रही है, विपक्ष को बता दीजिए किस विचारधारा के.
विपक्ष के उस लीडर को जवाब देने जो तर्क की बात करता हूँ.
आपने कहा कि विचारधारा महत्वपूर्ण है, तो मेरा प्रति प्रश्न है कि विचारधारा क्या आपको महसूस हो रहा है, बताइए. अरे भाई, आप जवाब दे नहीं है तो सरकार छोड़ दीजिए. सरकार
मिश्रा जी, बहुत एक सिंपल सवाल है आपसे. Mr. Hitesh Bajpayee, request you to be patient on this. Mr. Mishra, there is a very simple question. बहुत आसान सा सवाल है यहाँ पे. सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने काफी directions दिए थे पिछले साल, जिसमें स्टेट governments were responsible and they had to come up with mechanisms, they had to come up with measures to curb mob violence. Has your government been able to do that?
अमेरिका में भी ये मसला उठा था और हमारी सरकार ने एक माह पहले ही ओबीसी को लेकर कानून बनवाया है जिसमें 3 से 6 वर्षों की सजा का प्रावधान है. और अगर कोई ऐसी भी किसी भी चेहरे को ऐसे किसी भी विचार
मिश्रा
जी, अगर ऐसे प्रावधान आपकी सरकार ने किए हैं, अगर ऐसे प्रावधान आपकी सरकार ने किए हैं, तो दिन प्रतिदिन ऐसे घटनाएं क्यों हो रही है? एक ही दिन में एक ही जगह पे दो ऐसी घटनाएं कैसे हो सकती है? इसका यही मतलब है कि लोगों को वहां किसी भी चीज का डर नहीं है?
डर नहीं है, ये घटनाएं प्लानिंग से करवाई जा रही है सरकार को बदनाम करने के लिए, खुलासा करेंगे कि उनके पीछे कौन ताकतें हैं।
आपके कहने का ये मतलब है कि ये पॉलिटिकली मोटिवेटेड है? मिश्रा जी, आप ये कहना चाह रहे हैं कि सारी जो घटनाएं हो रही है, जितने भी केसेस ऑफ मॉब वायलेंस हो रहे हैं, क्या ये पॉलिटिकली मोटिवेटेड है?
एग्जैक्टली, आप उन आंकड़ों को भी देखिएगा कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी में या पूर्व मुख्यमंत्री शिवराज सिंह जी चौहान जनसभा में जिन जिन घटनाओं को लेकर धरना प्रदर्शन किया, वहां इस पार पर पहुंचे हैं, वहां 100% घटनाओं में भारतीय जनता पार्टी के नेता इन्वॉल्व है। भारतीय जनता पार्टी के लोगों का पैसे को लेन देन के लिए एक दूसरे की हत्याएं करवाई गई है, ये ऑन रिकॉर्ड है, ऑन रिकॉर्ड है, मैं अपने मन से नहीं कह रहा हूँ।
देखिए,
ये जब अकर्मण्य सरकार होती है, अक्षम सरकार होती है, तो वो इस प्रकार की बातों के पीछे छिपती है। आपके खुद विजुअल दिखा रहे हैं, जिला मुख्यालय पर ये वारदात हो रही है, सैकड़ों हजारों बच्चे इकट्ठे हैं, युवा इकट्ठे हैं जो ये हरकत कर रहे हैं, ये लॉलेसनेस वाले लोग हैं। अब आप बताइए, इनको मिश्रा जी सबको बचाना चाहते हैं, तो क्या भाजपा सरकारों में जो वारदातें होती थी वो मिश्रा जी करवाते थे? इसका ऐसा मान लिया जाए तो कांग्रेस सरकारों में जो हो रही है वो भाजपा का, ये तो कितना एक पोजीशन नहीं निकला, और उसके बावजूद भी आप उसको रोक ही नहीं पा रहे हैं। आप खुलासा करेंगे तो क्या सरकारें खुलासे के लिए बनाई जाती है, कार्रवाई के लिए बनाई जाती है?
इन लोगों का चरित्र सामने आ रहा है।
ऑलराइट
मिश्रा जी, चरित्र मत छोड़िए आप।
ऑलराइट, क्लियरली देयर इज नो रेजोल्यूशन इन साइट व्हेन इट कम्स टू द केसेस ऑफ मॉब वायलेंस कमिंग टू लाइट। वी हैव हर्ड फ्रॉम बोथ साइड, वी हैव हर्ड फ्रॉम द साइड ऑफ द बीजेपी, वी हैव हर्ड फ्रॉम द साइड ऑफ द कांग्रेस। इट इज क्लियरली ब्लेम गेम एट द एंड ऑफ द डे, विद द कांग्रेस स्पोक्सपर्सन क्लियरली सेइंग दैट दिस इज ऑल पॉलिटिकली मोटिवेटेड। व्हाट वी नीड is a concrete solution which either of the people are not able to give out for the moment. I'd like to thank both the spokespersons who've been joining us on the broadcast, Mr. K.K. Mishra and Mr. Hitesh Bajpai, with your views. But clearly this is a very serious issue and it really needs to be addressed at the earliest.